Here's a Sears stereo phonograph that I picked up over the weekend at the local antique radio and phonograph show. Very plain, just says Sears stereo system. Headphone jack, volume, balance, tone controls, and phono control, or it has auxiliary tape inputs in the back. It originally came with a set of speakers, which I did not get. It has a pretty standard BSR record changer. I'm going to date this at about, I don't know, the mid-70s, I'm not sure, early 70s. I paid $10 for it. It came with a dust cover that's not original. It has one of those very long Sears numbers on it. 132.9006 something or other. It's got the kind of raked back front I like. Wood grain around the sides and back. The only thing on the back is tape input jacks and speaker output jacks. And our lovely wood grain. It has the cartridge and stylus stock numbers on the back. All the regular adjustments. Anti-skate, height, set-down spots. It came with the owner's manual, which showed the two speakers I did not get. There's the long number for it. And I can't find much information about it. I can't find any information about this. I don't see any stock numbers for this anywhere. You can pause your screen and read this if you dare. Standard. It's always good to get the owner's manual for things. In this case, it's interesting because there's some owner who took notes here. It looks like he ordered a new stylus or cartridge. In July of 1990. So since I think this is maybe an earlier, maybe the mid-70s, this was in use for at least a long time. And my dust cover I got is a not a Sears, it's I think a Penny's, whoever made MCS. Is that Penny's? And of course it's always nice to get a schematic. See that on much modern electronics anymore, or any. And just for completeness, here's the dust cover I got. Fits on it a little okay, but not great. we have our record size set at 12 inches, speed selector 33rd, and our stylus selectors on the LP diamond side. Let's see what we get. I'll probably just play a little of this and then skip to the end and test out the automatic stop. Okay, operates okay. Let's set up for a 45. Alright, let's move our selector speed to, or size to 7 inches. Our speed to 45. We'll put the adapter on. And we'll give it a shot. If you don't recognize it. The turntable's got a little, more than a little, it's got a fairly significant warp to it. I guess I can't expect much more for $10. Let's try a 78. Elmer's tune, Foxtrot. 78. 10 inches. Stylus selector to the 78 side. One thing I've noticed is this has a real tight spot to fit the tone arm in when you're tone arm in when you're not using it. And if I forget to really pull it out hard when I start everything, of course nothing happens because the tone arm can't work its way out of the slot. that it rejects too. So all three speeds seem to work okay. Like I say, it's not a bad little phonograph for 10 bucks. The turntable, a platter, actually has some warpage to it. But I can live with that. It's really not a bad little unit. Maybe early 70s, 70-ish, I don't know. Couldn't find any information about it. But that's the Sears Stereo Phonograph. 132.9006 or something like that. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.